Hi, this is Dr. A of your cardiovascular system medical terminology videos over diagnostic procedures. All right, let's look at medical procedures. So auscultation is listening to sounds within the body using a stethoscope. Obviously here we'd be listening to the heart sounds. A sphygmomanometer is a blood pressure cuff and it measures blood pressure. Sphygmo means pulse and manometer is an instrument to measure pressure. A stethoscope is an instrument for listening to the body, body sounds. So stetho means chest, scope, it's actually linked to view, but to listen, to view the sounds, if you will. Angiogram is an x-ray record of a vessel. Angio is vessel. In angiography is the x-rays are taken after injection of the opaque dye into a blood vessel. So it's the process of getting an angiogram. A cardiac scan is a nuclear medicine scan that uses radioactive thallium. It is especially useful in determining myocardial damage. So, continuing here with diagnostic imaging. So, angiocardiography is our x-rays taken after an injection of the opaque dye into the blood vessel to evaluate the heart. And here's an example of an angiogram or an angiocardiogram, where you can see the dye causes the contrast to see these are the coronary arteries that feed the heart. Doppler ultrasonography is using ultrasound to produce an image of the blood flowing through the blood vessels in order to determine velocity, so how fast it's flowing through. It can indicate blood clots or deep vein thromboses. Echocardiography, or an echo, is the use of ultrasounds to visualize the internal cardiac structures, especially the valves, and see how the valves are opening and shutting and how the blood is flowing through the heart and how everything's working. Here is an example of what that looks like. This is an echocardiography. And then cardiac catheterization. A catheter is threaded through the blood vessel to the heart. It's usually threaded, started at the femoral artery, and goes up the aorta into the heart to look at the coronary circulation, and can detect abnormalities, collect cardiac blood samples, and it can also determine the blood pressure inside the heart. A catheter is a flexible tube that is inserted in the body to move fluids in or out of the body. It may be used to place a dye into a vein, which is what happens during cardiac catheterization. And then that dye allows them to view the blood vessel. You can also use it to insert a balloon or stent. We're going to look at some of that here in a minute. So here it is here. So this is angioplasty. So this is what you can do if during cardiac catheterization. So they can put the catheter comes in here, and then they can inject the dye to see the contrast and see where the blockage is. But then when they find the blockage, they can use the catheter to thread a deflated balloon through the opening. There still has to be an opening here. And then inflate the balloon to just kind of push that plaque open to open it up. And that opens up the narrowed artery so that blood can flow better. And then we're going to see, we can also put a stent in there. So this is stenting. So it's a balloon with stents. So the deflated balloon is pushed through the plaque. There has to be an opening. If it's completely occluded, it can't do it. And then the stent is almost like a Chinese finger trap thing. So you can have it small, and then when it inflates, it kind of locks into place, and then you can deflate the balloon and remove it, and the stent goes into the narrowed artery and props it open. So an electrocardiogram, ECG or EKG, depending on where you're from, is what they'll call it. It's a hard copy record that is produced by electrocardiography, and electrocardiography is a process of recording the electrical activity of the heart, or getting an EKG is what is usually referred to in the emergency room, for example. And this is able to diagnose arrhythmias and myocardial damage. A Holter monitor is a portable ECG monitor that is worn by a patient for up to a few days to assess heart activity as a person goes through daily activities. And this is to pick up and maybe some abnormalities that are happening just at a certain time of day or with a certain activity, but maybe not happening when they're in the doctor's office or in the clinic. Stress testing evaluates the cardiovascular fitness. The patient exercises on a treadmill or a bicycle with a steadily increasing workload, and then EKG and oxygen levels are monitored throughout the test. You can also do a chemical stress test where they inject chemicals to induce the same kind of workload that you would get by working on the treadmill, but without actually working on the treadmill. And then this is what a Holter monitor looks like. And so the patient would wear this for at least 24 hours. I've seen them even wear it for up to a month now because we have the capacity to record and store that data for longer periods of time now because of technology and miniaturization of everything. So, all right, that wraps up our diagnostic procedures for the cardiovascular system.